Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are keeping well. So, my name is Priyanka Singh and I am your science teacher. Today I am here to start with the chapter 7 of class 8 and the name of this chapter is Conservation of Plants and Animals. So, let's start this topic. With the increase in human population, the demand for natural resources has increased. Utilization and exploitation of resources at such fast rate is definitely causing the deflection because nature has only a limited amount of them in reserve. To protect these resources for future generation is known as conservation. Conservation. A wise and judicious use of all natural resources is called conservation. It is mainly concerned with the proper management, preservation and protection from misuse of natural resources. Conservation is mainly aimed at maintaining the essential ecological processes and the life support system, such as air, water, land, flora, that is plants, and fauna, that is animals. These life support systems are interdependent and interrelated. So, harm to one will affect the rest of the other elements of life support system. Preserving the quality of our environment. Provide resources to our future generation. Ensuring the proper and planned utilization of natural resources so that they are available for utilization. Preserving biological diversity, both genetic and ecological diversity. Deforestation, its causes. A great variety of plants and animals live on Earth. Today, a major threat to survival of these organisms is deforestation. We know that deforestation means clearing of forest and using that land for other purposes. Consequences. It increases the temperature and pollution level on the earth. It increases the level of CO2, carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, ground water level also gets lowered. So, it disturbs the balance of nature. Moreover, there are increased chances of natural calamities such as floods and droughts. Deforestation is a major cause which leads to changes in soil properties. Physical properties of the soil get affected by plantation and vegetation. Fewer trees results in more soil erosion. Removal of the top layer of soil exposes the lower, hard and rocky layer. This soil has less humus and is less fertile. Gradually, the fertile land gets converted into desert. It is called desertification. Habitat loss due to increase in human population. Because of great increase in human population in the last 70 years, more and more land is needed for agriculture and housing, for making grounds and for constructing dams, bridges, powerhouses and industries. This led to the rapid decline of biodiversity. Pollution. Air, water and soil get polluted with insecticides used as agriculture. Toxic elements released from industries and petroleum products. This causes loss of biodiversity. Introduction of exotic species. The species introduced into a new locality compete with the species already existing in that area and may cause extinction of some native species. Now, climatic changes. Human activities are causing changes in the temperature and rainfall patterns. These are responsible for global warming and melting of glaciers. Such changes have adverse effects on biodiversity. So, students, this is the diagram showing number of living species of all organisms currently known. So, go through it. Biodiversity. What is biodiversity? It is the variety of different types of life found on the earth and it gets used a measure of the health of biological systems and see if there is a danger that too many species become extinct. Conservation of biodiversity. There are a number of resources on the earth which are being used up for various human activities. In this process, a lot of waste is also generated, which is harmful and also pollute the environment. This causes a lot of damage to the environment, which indirectly affects the biodiversity. It is due to some of these reasons that many plants and animals have now become extinct. Benefits of biodiversity. Fresh water, good soil, clean air, enough oxygen, etc. are some of the gifts given to us by our biodiversity. Biodiversity has various advantages. Some of them are listed below. So, pollination of flowers by the interaction of butterflies and insects is due to our intense biodiversity. Forests are the home of many animals and support many plant species. The balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide is maintained in the atmosphere due to biodiversity. Many valuable producers like wood, pulp, gums, resins, medicines and fruit come from the forests. Forests prevent soil erosion and flood. Natural processes like growth of plants, reproduction in animals, etc. are governed by biodiversity. Weather is also controlled by it. Threats to biodiversity. Biodiversity faces a number of dangers, most of which are the causes of human activity. Destruction of habitat. The primary cause of the loss of biodiversity is the destruction of habitat. Due to the increased population, the need of land for housing, increasing demand for agriculture, increased demand for land to set up industries, forests have to be cut down. The final outcome is the loss of in biodiversity. Pollution. Pollution can be compared to any poison. It poisons the land, water, and air. Pollution even brings about a change in the climatic conditions of a place. The pollutants released from industries, vehicles, etc. cause harm to the environment, which endangers the biodiversity. This ultimately results into the death of living beings and destruction of habitat. Now, over-exploitation by humans. Human activities cause a lot of harm to the biodiversity. The natural ecosystem is affected because of the personal interest of human beings. They exploit the biodiversity for food, construction, industrial products, trade, fashion, and medicines. Whenever an individual species is subjected to human exploitation, it brings about an imbalance in the nature. This harms other species also. Climatic changes. Burning of fuels lead to emission of gases like carbon dioxide, which is responsible for the greenhouse effect. This is further responsible for global warming, which is a major threat to biodiversity. So students, these are the picture showing, like first picture is of forest, and this picture is showing the forest is being cutting down. The next picture is showing an industry causing pollution. And after that, there is a picture who is showing human over-exploitation can cause harm to various animal species. So, the next is IUCN. IUCN, what is it? It stands for the International Union for the Conservation of Nature. An organization which works towards the global conservation of plants, animals and the habitats. It encourages, initiates and assists the various conservation societies throughout the world. Founded in 1948. It is located in Geneva in Switzerland. It consists of 83 working states, 108 government agencies, 766 NGOs, 81 international organizations, and about 10,000 scientists from all over the world. The IUCN maintains a red list, which is a compilation of endangered wildlife species. It also maintains a red data book, which provides data on population status of the species included in the red list. The first red data book of animals was compiled in 1991, as shown in the picture. Both the red list and red data book show the risk of extinction of plants and animals by categorizing them as extinct, critically endangered, and vulnerable. So, it's time for activity. So, From the internet, collect information about at least 10 species of animals which are in the red list and find mention in the red data book. Is there any animal in your area from the list? What conservation measures are being taken by your state government? Collect information and keep a record of it. So, what is a species? Species is a group of living organisms consisting of similar individuals which are capable of exchanging genes of interbreeding. This means that the members of a species can reproduce fertile offsprings only with the members of their own species and not with members of other species. Members of a species have common characteristics. Several species have become extinct or are on the verge of extinction due to human intervention. Endangered or threatened species. An endangered species refers to a group of those organisms which are at the risk of becoming extinct. They may be endangered due to many factors, the most important of which may be climatic conditions. Steps are being taken by different countries to protect these species. Complete ban on hunting. Protecting natural habitats are some of the steps taken for the conservation of endangered species. So, these are the pictures of endangered species, and these showing rhino, white tiger, and owl. Extinct species. Extinct species are those plants or animals that are no more into existence. Probably, they became extinct because other species were more successful in survival. Natural disasters could also be one of the causes for the species being extinct. Climatic conditions and human activities are also some of the causes that cannot be ruled out. At present, the most vulnerable cause in human activities. According to the estimates, around 125 species of birds and 60 species of mammals have become extinct so far. Now, vulnerable species. These are species that are declining but still have sufficient number of individuals in their natural habitat. However, in near future, they might represent the category of endangered species in case the causal factors for their decline are not removed. Musk deer, sambar, spotted deer are a few examples of vulnerable species. Rare species. These are localized in certain geographical area and exhibit scattered population considering the global environment. Thus, their overall population in the world is small. In future, they may enter the category of vulnerable or endangered species. Indian elephant, wild buffalo, and Asiatic wild elk are a few examples. And here are the pictures of some. Endemic species. Those species of plants and animals which are found exclusively in a particular area are called endemic species. They are not naturally found anywhere else. Sal and wild mango are two examples of endemic flora of Pachmadi Biosphere Reserve. Conservation. How? There are various methods that can be employed to conserve the endangered species. The primary step could be to captivate the endangered species. But this, however, cannot exist for a long period as they need habitual places to live and survive. To make it available for them, we need to conserve forests. In spite of the growing needs of the population, we need to realize the importance of a healthy ecosystem. The government has undertaken various steps to conserve the ecosystem and the endangered species. Some efforts made by the government are given below. Forest resources. The protected area under the India Forest Act 1972 are termed as forest resources. They are large areas protected from human interference and exploitation. Deforestation is strictly prohibited in these areas. National parks and sanctuaries. Just like forest resources, national parks and sanctuaries also provide protection to biodiversity. A sanctuary is a place where killing or capturing animals is strictly prohibited. There are around 3,096 national parks and sanctuaries all over the world. India almost has 515 wildlife sanctuaries and 105 national parks. Some of the national parks are Jim Corbett National Park at Nainital in Uttarakhand, Sariska National Park in Rajasthan, Kaziranga National Park in Assam. Some of the famous sanctuaries are Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary at Bharatpur in Rajasthan, Kallakaddu Sanctuary in Tamil Nadu, Madhumali Sanctuary at Nadipur, Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary in Kerala. So, it's an activity. Visit a national park or a sanctuary located in your area. Which animals are being protected there? Do they belong to endangered species? How are the human being keeping a check on the hunting? Write all the details in your notebook. So students, are you able to see this table? This table is showing important national parks and sanctuaries in India. Although in India, there are 515 sanctuaries and national parks. But here are some important ones. So on first number, it is Jim Corbett National Park and it is in Uttarakhand. On second number, it is Palamau National Park. It is in Madhya Pradesh. On third number, it is Gir Wildlife Sanctuary. It is in Gujarat. Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary, which is in Rajasthan. Sultanpur Lake Bird Sanctuary, it is in Haryana. Kaziranga Wild Sanctuary is in Assam. Bandipur National Park is in Karnataka. Periyar National Park is in Kerala. Now, botanical gardens. These are the places where numerous varieties of plants are grown. These plants are generally of medicinal use. These gardens are maintained by botanists and horticulturists. These gardens are a great help in educating the people about the endangered species of plants. Seed bank. Seeds are dried and deep frozen to be stored in a seed bank. By doing so, many varieties of seeds can last for centuries. Most of the seeds stored there include crop plant. The Svalbard Global Seed Vault, Norway, is the world's biggest secure seed bank. Zoological parks. Zoo is a place frequently visited by people. The plants and animals are kept here in natural kinds of an environment. Many zoos try to breed endangered species and take good care of them. Difference between a national park and a zoo. In a national park, wild animals live in their natural habitats and use natural resources, whereas in a zoo, wild animals kept in cages in captivity. Hunting regulations. Strict laws are needed to regulate hunting or poaching of animals. Hunting of endangered species should be banned. Destruction of natural habitats of wild animals should be prevented. Captive breeding. Breeding wild animals in captivity has saved some species from extinction. Example, musk deer in Garhwal Hills, lion in Gir Forest, and ghadiyal in Nandakanan Zoological Park in Odisha. Wildlife breeding projects in India. The government of India has started some breeding projects to save the endangered species. Some of them are Project Tiger, Green Lion Project, Crocodile Breeding Project, Himalayan Musk Deer Project, Rhino Conservation Project, etc. Project Tiger. Project Tiger was launched in 1973 to save tiger from poaching under this project. 28 tiger reserves have been established in India. Gir Lion Project. This project was started by the government of Gujarat in 1972 to protect the Asiatic lion. Now, migration. When animals move in masses to a different habitat owing to climate changes, it is said to be migration. Migration is done mainly for the sake of reproduction. Seeking food and water is another cause for migration. Forests and paper. Paper is made from wood pulp. Roughly 17 full-grown trees are required to make 1 ton of paper. Saving paper therefore means saving trees. It also means saving energy and water needed to manufacture paper, as well as reduction in pollution by reducing use of harmful chemicals required in making paper. Reforestation. Reforestation refers to the various steps taken by the government to set a forest. Setting up a forest once again would include planting trees, and then obviously existence of different varieties of birds and animals would take place. So students, it's time for Reader's Digest. Forests are useful to us in many ways. Deforestation is the cutting down of forest and using the land for other purposes. Biodiversity includes many kinds of living things, from microorganisms to human beings on this earth. Biodiversity varies with climatic conditions. The Red List and the Red Data Book show species at the risk of extinction. Reforestation refers to the various steps taken by the government to set a forest. So students, it's time to take your leave. So we'll meet in the next class. Bye.